Hi guys, in this tutorial I would like to show how to create an image carousel, like you see in a lot of websites, I guess. In mobile it works a bit different because in mobile we can do it with a swipe, with a drag interaction. Here I just want to see the scroll with the arrows, with the side arrows. So I kind of like build a primary structure of a website which has an header and the hero image, which usually you will see in a lot of kind of like e-commerce websites or other websites as well. But I'm not doing the carousel on this part, actually I'm doing it on this part. Okay, so we have two things going on here. While hovering, we're gonna see these arrows appearing here that we can click on them and scroll this carousel. And when I click on each one of them, so you will see that I'm creating this beautiful animation, kind of like grow into the middle thing. And this is what we are shooting for in this tutorial. So with no further ado, let's jump in and see exactly how to do it. Okay, so the only thing which I pre-made here, just not to waste time on it, I feel these shapes from Unsplash, from this plugin, this one, Unsplash. I just feel these images inside these shapes, or let's more right to say feel the shapes with these images. And there's one big on the middle, and all the other shapes are a bit smaller than him. It really doesn't matter because you can do it any size, any shape that you want in your designs. It really doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is to understand how to create it in the technical slash logical way. Okay, they're all sitting together in an auto layout which holds them together. Okay, and it helps me just make these quick changes, make one image bigger and bring back this one to these size. You will see how it goes. By the way, if you're not familiar with auto layout, I do have another tutorial on an auto layout, I think maybe even more than one, so check it out. It will help you understand it better. And components and interactive components that we will work with here in this tutorial. So if you're not familiar with it, I guess you should take a step back, understand components and variants better, and get back to this tutorial. Okay, the other thing that we have to do is I want to place this auto layout in a frame that will hold it, that we can scroll all these images inside it. So I'm going to create a frame which is going to be 1920. Oh, that went precise, which is good. The size actually doesn't really matter that much. I mean, the height, it can be something like that, which is good. I'm going to call it image scroll, and I'm going to place this one inside it. So this is actually what we are getting, because we do need a frame to hold it that we can scroll inside it. Okay, you will understand in a sec. If you don't, so, or maybe you do, so that's okay. Image scroll, and the name here doesn't matter that much. You know what, I'll just leave it as images. And this one, actually, I'm gonna call it an image scroll. I'll just call it one. I'm gonna give them numbers. It doesn't matter. It's gonna work perfect. Okay, so the other one that I will make is here. Now I'm gonna use these. Usually I don't work with rulers, but this time I will, because I want these rulers. And by the way, we can deselect this clip content so we can see the images outside. We don't really need the fill. I'm just leaving it to have a better view on where exactly our images inside this frame. So I'm just gonna do one here and do one here, which is going to help us actually to place these images more precise like that. Actually, you know what? I don't need the guidelines. What I do need, you know what? I'll leave them for now. Okay. I'm kind of like having a conflict with myself. Do it or not do it, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so clicking on this image, maintain proportions, which is good. I'm going to give it a, this one, by the way, is 540 on 300 of height. And the smaller ones are 450 and 250. Again, I'm just remembering it for my images. In your images or in your designs, you will do whatever you want. It really doesn't matter. Okay, so selecting this one, giving it a 540, and it makes it exactly the size of this one. I'm working with an auto layout, so it's very easy to do that. And this one, I will give it a 450. Sorry, I need to click on the proportions. So 450, and now it works fine. And what I'm gonna do now is actually I'm gonna scroll it to these guidelines, but I see that it's not working very good. Maybe I can fix it a bit here. I mean, yeah, that's okay. I guess that's okay. Or maybe we can do it here as well. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, no, it's not really that fine. It's not really that precise. Let me see. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, it doesn't have to be, even if we kind of like skipped pixel one to the left or one to the right, it doesn't really matter that much, honestly speaking. That's okay. Okay, so we have this one, and let's do another one quickly. Yeah, and double click on this one, 540, and this one is going to be 450, and we're gonna do the same, scroll it kind of like, let's see. Yeah, that's okay. I mean, basically that's okay. As I told you, pixel left and right, it doesn't really matter that much, honestly. So that's okay. And let's do the back ones. I mean, going to the other side ones. Let's put this here. I'm gonna do it really quickly again. Okay. Yeah, so that's gonna be 540, and this is going to be, and this one will be 450. Okay, and we're gonna scroll it again here. That's, oh, because I duplicated with the guideline, so it did that work for me already, which is good. And yeah, let's do a last one. That's okay, I think it will be understood enough. Let me see, 450. Okay, good, and we're gonna scroll all this auto layout up to here. Good. Okay, so we have it already set up. Yeah, I can put the clip content, and then we see it like that. And I'm gonna create a component set from all of them together. Create component set. So now we have the image scroll with all these states inside it. Okay, this is part one of our preparations for the image scroll. And the part two is going to be another frame. 1920, yeah, that's okay. It can be like 140, I think, something like that. That's okay. And we're gonna give it a scroll arrows, and now I will give it a hover. I'm doing the hover first because I'm doing the arrows first. And the arrows are going to be something like, I guess 60 by 60 looks fine to me. Let me see. Yeah, that's okay. I see. I mean, I just see how the size sits on the image, so it looks okay. I'm gonna call it a left arrow. Good. I'll make it round. Oh, sorry, that's not what I meant. I meant here. I'll give it a 30 and let's create a quick arrow. Okay, something like that. Yeah, good. Works for me. Great. That's okay. So we did an arrow and let's duplicate it. I'll flip it horizontal, or I can do just a shift H on a Mac and a PC and I'm just flipping it. I will call it a right arrow. Good. So we can take them both and place them here. We don't need actually the, I'm just leaving it for a sec just to see where the arrows sit, and then I will take the, let's give it a 40, that's okay. We can fine tune it later. I just want to see, where the arrows are sitting. Yeah, I'm just taking it here. Okay. And I'm measuring to see that I am 40. Good. Okay, so I'm in the middle. Okay, good. So now I will duplicate it. Okay, so we have the hover, and this is going to be the default. Okay, in the default, I'm gonna make these two arrows opacity 0. Of course, I will take I will hide or take off the fill of this frame, and I will combine them as component set. Okay, component set, and this one I'm gonna go into prototype and connect it with change to this variant, and it's gonna happen while hovering. Okay, while hovering, smart animate 200 milliseconds looks fine to me. Now I am copying this one. I'm gonna select this frame, okay, and paste it here. I'm gonna paste it here inside this component. So I have the scroll arrows, I can see them here, okay, and I will make sure it's aligned to the middle, okay, and like that. Good. I will copy, I'm copying it from this frame, okay, from, why I'm doing it from here, because when I select this frame and paste it, it's gonna paste it exactly where I put it here, which helps and makes it quickly. So I'm gonna do them like one after the other. That's it. So the other thing which I will do now, as before I'm starting to hook up the interaction itself, I'm gonna take the first one, or let me take actually, let me take the mid one. Copy. I'm selecting this frame and paste. Okay, so I've pasted it here. I'm gonna place it here. And now let me do the play and just see that our hover mode works. Okay, so fit width, and okay, great. So we have the hover mode. One thing I do want to do actually is I want to set the color of the background color of this frame of the arrow. I want to set it to like, I think 80%. Let me see how it looks. Let's see it now. Yeah, it's better. Okay, that works good. I'm wondering about distance from the, yeah, that's okay, it doesn't matter that much. Okay, that's fine, I'm fine with that. Okay, so now here comes the trick. So now it starts, actually we're starting to hook up all these variants for the interactions. Now look how we do that. So I will double click on this component, double click. Okay, I'm reminding you that it's this one. Okay, and I will switch to the hover. When I switch to the hover mode, now I can actually connect the arrows to the next variant. So at this point, I will connect this one, okay, to this variant. If we had, by the way, another one, smart animate, yeah, 500 milliseconds, that's okay. If we had another variant of more images, then I could connect also this one to it, but I didn't do. I will just do kind of like two clicks to the left, two clicks to the right, just to get the hang of it. Of course, in your designs, you can keep on connecting more and more variants, but it's just to understand logically how it works. Okay, so this is for me my last one. I'm connecting it back to here. Now I will switch it back. Okay, I'm gonna switch it back to the default, and here I'm gonna switching to the hover, and I will do the same. Actually, I will connect this arrow here. Notice that I am doing it from the hover mode and not from the default, okay? Because when I hover on it, these arrows show up, and then I connect them to the variants. This is the way it works. And this one I will connect back to here. And I will switch it back to the default, and here as well, switching to the hover, doing exactly the same thing all over again. I'm gonna do it like really quickly. And we have two more. Yeah, I'm just working quickly now. Okay, so this will come to here, and this will be connected to this one. And set last one, I guess. I will switch it back to the default, and this one actually, hover, and this one will be connected here. And I guess that we are pretty much done. Okay, let's give it a test drive. And see how it works. I'm gonna play it again. Sometimes it doesn't really kind of like reloads correctly the interactive components. Okay, so we are starting from, this is our wonderful image carousel. Click here, great, so it works nice, and click here, and now great. Now two clicks to here, and we are done. Great. So as I said, you can keep and making actually more variants and keep connecting them and moving, you know, the carousels more to the left and more to the right, and then creating more animations to it. But basically it works really nice, and this is the great way of doing that. And that's about it, guys, for this tutorial. So I hope it was knowledgeable and gave you a good idea of how to create that. And always happy to give these great tutorials. Thank you for watching, and thank you for being interested in my tutorial. I would be really happy with a like if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel. And see you, of course, hopefully in the next tutorial. Thank you so much, guys, and have a great work coming up ahead. Thank you. Bye for now.